people and welcome. We will see here how to use Adobe Audition CC. If you're looking for something in detail, check the index in the video description. Leave feedbacks to help us improving our pronunciation. So, what is Audition CC? Audition is not a DAW, a digital audio workstation software. It is a program that helps you editing music. It is quite useful if you want to edit fast a song or a sample without knowing anything in detail about audio production. As its name says, you can work with samples only, such as .wav, .mp3 and so on. You can't import or edit MIDI files at all, and you don't have any piano roll. Your workspace is composed by several parts. By default, on the left, you have all the windows opened that list files or let you browse them. On the right, you have the main workspace, the editor window, where you're going to create your project. Then, at the bottom, you have some information shown, and, on top, the menu bar and some quick options. Before starting, keep in mind that you have two ways to work with your project. You can work with a single sample to edit it properly, or you can work with more of them altogether. Let's see how. To import any sample file, just click and drag them in the files window. Remember that if you don't find windows because closed, you can go to the menu bar and to window. The windows checked are the ones opened and visible. Click on the one interested to open it from here. The files window lists all the files ready to be used, without looking for them through your hard drive. The files that can be added are all the ones that have sound. You can add videos without problems, too. Mind that the audio part of the video is a sample aside. Each file is recognized through its icon on the left. The green waveform means a single sample file, the frame a video, and the small block a session. A session is your entire project composed by multiple sample files. Let's see how to edit a sample file. Open its waveform double-clicking on the file imported. The editor window will be opened on the right, showing you a full description of such file. On top you have the whole waveform of both right and left channels for stereo music. This transparent bar is used to move through the waveform. Hold Alt down and use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out. Otherwise, just right-click and drag on the timeline to zoom in such region. A little below, the waveform is shown bigger. The left channel is indicated through the letter L, and the right one with the letter R. Click on such letters to disable the related channel interested. A channel disabled is muted and locked as well. That means that you can edit it at all, unless you activate the channel again. Click now the red rectangle button right below the menu bar. This will show you another graph that represents the frequency spectrum of the signal, which means seeing, for each frequency indicated on the right, the intensity of the signal. If the color gets close to red or yellow, the intensity is really high. Notice that the frequency scale is logarithmic by default. So the vertical distance between two points is increased, as much as you go up. You can manage room between the waveform and the spectrum. Just click and drag up or down the thick gray line between the two graphs. At the bottom you have the player and info panels. To play and pause fast the song, just press space from your keyboard. Click on this icon to activate loop, so that when the waveform reaches its end, it starts again from the beginning. Watch out the levels below. This is called dB meter or decibel meter and reveals the intensity of the output signal in time. Make sure it never gets too close to red or you will get the signal distorted. Let's see how to edit this track. Before this, remember that you can always undo any action in case you mistake. To undo the latest action, just press Ctrl and Z or go to Edit and then to Undo. To go more backwards, open the History window and delete as many actions as you like. so don't be worried when you mistake. To select a part of the waveform, just click and drag on the left or right. The part selected will be highlighted in white. Then you can start editing it. For example, you can quickly cut, copy or paste it using Ctrl and X, Ctrl and C and Ctrl and V. When you paste the piece selected, this part will be added right after the red playhead. Whenever you need, there is always a very small block that shows a dB knob. This adjusts the intensity of the sound, making it louder or less. 0 dB means using the original intensity. If you selected just a part of the waveform, this will affect just such part. Let's see how to add effects. Go to Effects Rack. If you don't find it, simply open it through the Windows section. This window shows you the full list of effects used in the sample file opened. Go in the small white arrow on the right to add an effect in the row interested. Then simply choose between the list of effects available. A new window will show up to make you change the settings of such effect. It is pretty useful to play the track over and over while setting the effect. In this way you will be able to apply the kind of effect that fits more what you are looking for. Keep in mind the I/O button in the bottom left corner of the window. This puts on and off the effect live, so that you can hear how the sample is before and after such effect. The effect just added will appear in the list, occupying a row. You can delete or edit it anytime, simply right-clicking on it. You can change it with another effect, going again to the white arrow on the right. Then you can activate or deactivate it anytime, going to the I/O button on the left. If you want to learn more about audio effects, just watch the relative video in this show. The effect will be applied permanently once you click on the Apply button. The Process option on the right sets where the effect has to be applied, on the whole track or just on the selected part at the moment. The effects applied will be all the ones that have a green I/O button. If you don't use the Apply button, you can hear the effects on, but these are not applied when, for example, you render the track. You can eventually put a bigger time display if you need. Go to Window and open the Window Time. Let's now see the second mode, called Multitrack mode. This mode works on a collection of more sample files, called Session, in .cesx format, that can be put together to create a more complex file altogether. Click on Multitrack button. You will need to save it first, so choose its name and its location through Browse. In this mode, all is the same, such as Windows on the left and the Windows at the bottom. What changes is the editor window. Click and drag sample files to add in the tracks. Each track collects more than a sample file and are put as rows. On top you see the same navigation bar, semi-transparent, that shows you how the whole project is. The sample files added are represented through small green strips. You can use this bar to move through your project and eventually to zoom in and out. Hold Ctrl down and use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out the tracks. Hold Alt down to zoom vertically between the tracks. You have the timeline right below, measured in seconds and minutes. You can change the time measurement right-clicking on it. You can manage each track very easily. Drag it to move it on the left or right, or in another different track. Use the squares near its edges to put some fade. Notice that, if you make overlaps between two sample files in a same track, a crossfade is made auto, so that when the track is being played, the sound in output passes from one file to the following one in a smooth way. Then drag the edges of a clip to change its length. There are many ways to edit these clips more in detail. Check the video dedicated to effects to go more into deep. In these tracks you can add a video as well, however, just its sound file can be modified. Its sound file is considered as a different sample file with a similar name. the visible frames will occupy an independent track and can be edited. You can watch the video through the video window. At the very bottom, you find the master track. This track collects all the other tracks you have above. Any effect, for example the volume, that affects the master, will affect any sound in output. Keep in mind the time selection tool. This is useful to select multiple samples or edit just parts of them. Click and drag to create a selection area through a dashed rectangle. All that falls inside will be selected. Samples selected are moved and edited together. You can use this tool to select just a part of the sample to cut and paste it elsewhere. On the left of each track, you have further options. Double-click on the track's name to change it. This is quite useful when you start working with complex projects. Click and drag a track to move it up and down. Then you have two different knobs. The left one is the volume that sets the intensity of the track. The right one is the panning that distributes the intensity between the left and right channel. Mind that these knobs will affect the whole track, so all the clips inside such track. Then, on the right, you have some other buttons, for example the S and the M buttons. M means mute and simply puts off the whole track. Its clips will be shown without any color. S means solo and it's the opposite. All the other tracks will be muted, so that you can hear the track interested all alone. Click again on the buttons to come back to normal. Then, on the right, you have a small dB meter related to the track. Make sure that these two rectangles on top never get red. New in Audition CC is the ability to give colors to each track. Just click on the small square you see at the bottom. Let's see now how to save your tracks. In waveform mode, this is very simple, because the sample file is saved directly when you press Ctrl and S, or go to File and then to Save. In multi-track it's different, since you work with a .sesx file and not a direct sound file. In this case you need to render your project. To do this, just go to File and then to Export, and to mix down multi-track. Through this window you can change the render settings. Change the name on top, choose the destination folder through Browse and choose its format. More at the bottom in Mixdown options, you can choose whether to render just the project in full or plus single tracks as well. Go to Change on the right and then to Tracks section and select which is the track to render besides the full project. Then just go to OK and it's done. Well, this is all. I hope this helped you. Check the following videos to know more about Adobe Audition CC. Thanks for watching.